Yes, Adefope is a man of honor. He's a straightforward person.
He's an awesome person to work with.
A very hardworking person.
Full of life.
Stickler for details.
I think one word comes out more than anything else, and that's integrity.
He is disciplined.
He has a charming and disarming humility.
I mean, he is humility simplified.
He's like humble to your fault.
This man is an amazing woman. You know those Queen's English?
He really does have class and intelligence.
Very perfect gentleman.
Very, very respectful.
And very simple man.
He's always there to assist.
He's a strong man. He's a very hard man.
Very intuitive.
He's wise. Very wise.
He's got to be one of the most special guys in the world.
He's a very... I don't know. He's just too much.
My history with him is a very memorable one. He's a part of my life. For me, he's family.
He has moved on from being just my employer. He's more like a father.
One thing with him is that he identifies good things in people and he tries to help them develop, especially young people. So that's why you see a lot of people who started out maybe in the last 10, 15, 20 years and up until now, a number of us are still working with him.
Regardless of where we're all coming from, we are part of that big family that he has now created.
It has been fun working with him for the past 7 years.
Almost 13 years.
About 14, 15 years.
18 years now.
Let's say 12 years.
In 2008.
For like 21 years now.
14 good years.
17 years.
Okay, I've known him for over 40 years, so...
Can I calculate? Let me say 7, 8, 9 years.
I met him first, I think it was in 1991.
A little over 12 years.
I've known him for almost 20 years.
He's more or less a father to everybody, yeah?
He's like a father to me.
I don't really see him as my boss because I bring more of personal issues to him than even official issues.
He's a father to me. He's my mentor.
He's a friend.
If I needed to talk to anybody, if I needed to cry to anybody, if I needed somebody who was going to talk to me unbiased without thinking about, you know, just give me an unbiased opinion, I went to him.
The door is always open for everybody to complain to and is there to advise.
He calls us his bosses. And you think that he's just like every other person. But the thing is, he walks straight down to you. He's always giving you a smile. How may I help you, sir?
You might not know that he's the boss. Because of the way he relates with everybody, you know, jokes with us, you yab him, he yabs you.
It's a rare thing to find in someone that, you know, high up. He's very humble. Most people come into this office and just don't know that he is the owner of the business. And he tells you he's the messenger. But his humility knows no bounds.
He doesn't want you to see him far off there as an MD or a chairman. He comes down to your level every time you need to talk to him. He wants you to see him as a friend. So I think it's somebody who is free.
When we go out together, he's always proud to associate himself with us. No matter who he's with, he would always call you, oh, come and meet my colleagues, meet this, meet that. Even if my guy is the president of Nigeria, US president, he will introduce you to him as his colleagues.
Initially, I used to sit at the back of my car when I'm driven by my driver. But having seen Mr. Adefope, he was sitting in front, The first time I saw it, I thought maybe there was an error somewhere. Maybe the basket was soaked or something. And when I asked questions, and the monitor closed, I saw that consistently he sits in front of his car. I said myself, how can I myself, a human who is not even anywhere yet? So I began to sit at the back. I began to sit in front of my car together with my driver. And also, I also noticed that where I have my office, that most people now who were initially sitting at the back would not come to me and say, oh boy, I like the way you operate, too, that they now sit in front. So he has influenced me, and I've also influenced other people.
He has his goals, he has the standards, and he has specifically what his expectations are for his employees.
You got to be serious when you work with him. You have to be hard working.
I mean, you have to be straight to the point. You have to have confidence in yourself. When he's there, he asks you a question, you have to give him a straight answer.
You know, it's almost like he knows some extras that you don't know, that you don't see.
He can knock you off easily if you don't know what you're doing. He needs to see the confidence in you for you to get his attention.
You know, it's a pleasure to work with him because he's got all this experience, but he's still willing to learn. He takes the time with the younger people to coach them. He uses his experience to make all of our work better.
It's actually been a plus working with Adefope. He has really added value to the WB business.
Everybody, when they're talking about Nigeria market, they're not talking about Nigeria market as this company I represent, Air Cote d'Ivoire. They said Mr. Adefope because of what, of the value or the quality of the man. And for me, when your management at the top give this kind of consideration and the respect of a partner, I think is there are no more story. It's only to get more with this man.
If I need to rate him, I think for a boss, a friend, a father, I will give him 90% because he's always interested in your welfare and whatever will take you forward. He's always happy with you, happy when you are progressing, happy when your family is progressing. I don't think anybody deserves a better boss than my MD.
We used to call him 007.
Call him Gizbon.
There was nothing you could hide from him, you know. He would find everything.
Anything that happened, even up to the gates, he monitored the gates.
You can't hide away from him. He will get you. Anywhere you are, he will get you.
We call him James Bond in those days because when he comes to you, he comes straight to your system and he wants to see what you're doing right there.
You just be doing your work. And then all of a sudden, you see MD behind you. As in, when did this man walk to this place? So we used to say that man will just appear. He won't come, he will just appear.
It's James Bond. He's an actor.
He has actually grown now from 007 to being a father. He's more of a father figure for most of us.